They say that repentance isn't turning from sin, it's merely turning from unbelief. Now, this is true for both the ancient antinomians and the modern antinomians. Jack Hyles notoriously redefined repentance as only being from unbelief. He said this: there are those who say we have to repent of our sins in order to be saved. No, we have to repent only of the thing that makes us unsaved, and that is unbelief. Well, that's wrong on two counts, but we'll get into that in a later chapter. Jesus himself is saying repent, and notice immediately he says repent and believe. What he was saying is quit unbelieving and believe. Quit not believing and believe. Well, Jesus was pretty redundant then. That's ridiculous. But anyway, where did Jack Hyles get this? Did he invent this? No. He got this from the tired old arguments that have already been acknowledged as heresy by their author, Agricola, the old antinomian argument in which he said, quote, in the gospel, we are not to deal with doing violence to the law. In other words, we're not to deal with sin, but with doing violence to the Son, or unbelief. So he says the law is not about dealing with sin, but about unbelief. Another quote, Peter taught repentance from the profaning of the Son, or unbelief. Peter was a preacher. Therefore, preachers should teach repentance from the profaning of the Son, not from the law of Moses. So they're not to teach that sin, or that repentance is to turn from sin, but that it is to turn from unbelief in the Son of God. What do you know? So this argument is not new. Now, it doesn't go all the way back to the apostles and the early church, and I would argue that it is, in fact, in the very next chapter, we're going to argue that it is a somewhat new heresy. It's only 500 years old. This is not the gospel received of the saints and accepted for 2,000 years by God's churches. It is a relatively modern heresy, but it is not just 50 years old. It goes all the way back to the ancient antinomian controversy. Now, I don't know a single antinomian who would admit that he's an antinomian, and he would never want to be compared with the antinomians because they've been soundly refuted and shown wrong. But that's exactly what antinomianism is, modern easy believism. That's exactly what it is. It's the old sect of antinomianism, the ancient deception that has been soundly refuted.